Hey guys, welcome back. And today I am going to be doing a tag, and this is called If You Could Only Keep One. And it was Lauren May who I saw that inspired me to do this, but it was a tag that was created by Kelly. I'm gonna link their videos down below. This is also a video that's in collaboration with Mr. Kendenis, or formerly known as the Pop Air. And he is a Melbourne-based Filipino who is now Australian, and he is a beauty vlogger as well. So I thought that I'd reach out to him and ask if he wanted to do a collab, and he was really nice and said yes. So I thought, well, let's give it a go. Now, I don't know if I should be mentioning a primer because I don't really use primer. I know I've got oily combo skin, but now that it's coming into winter, it's turning into more of a normal kind of skin. And to be honest, I am not really somebody who wears primer all the time. It's a step that I skip most of the time. I do moisturize my skin and tone before I put on makeup. I just don't really use primer that much. I don't know. So I don't think I'm going to mention that because honestly, it's not part of my routine. However, part of my routine is an eye primer because I've got really super duper uber oily lids. And if I don't use a primer, my eyeshadow is going to crease within the hour. I've tried a lot of eye primers because of that problem, and the only one that seems to have worked for me time and time again is the NARS Pro Prime Smudge Proof Eyeshadow Base. Now this is the one that's already in my empties. I do have a backup of it. I haven't opened it because I am using up my Milani eyeshadow primer. This is nothing like this. I wish it was, because a lot of people said that it was. I wish it was, but it's not. If you have super duper oily lids and you're thinking that this might be a substitute for this, it isn't. This by far is still the best one that I've had. No creasing, 12 to 14 hours wear, nothing. This, after 8 hours, is gone, honestly. Okay, for brow products, I don't actually have it with me, but it is for pencil. I do really like the NYX micro brow pencil. Plus it's so much cheaper than the Anastasia one. I haven't tried the Anastasia one, but I do like the micro brow from NYX, so I don't really feel the need to buy anything else because it works really well for me. I am currently using the Anastasia dip brow, but I'm not sure if I like that. I feel like I prefer actually the Tarte Amazonian clay brow mousse over the Anastasia one. It just works better for me. Maybe it is because of my oily skin as well. It's just that the dip brow, I don't know. I use it because I have it, but it's not my favorite. My favorite still remains as the Tarte Amazonian Clay Brow Mousse in Rich Brown. Okay, there you go. For foundation, I have tried a lot of foundation. I was a foundation junkie at one point, and probably if you've been with me for a while, you would know that I've been trying foundations for a long time, a lot of the time. And in that quest, before it used to be the MAC Studio Fix Fluid, which I still have. I actually got two shades of them right now in my collection, and it's also the foundation that I'm using today. But to be honest with you guys, I really do prefer the IT Cosmetics CC Cream. Now, I know that this is not a foundation per se, but it is. It works pretty much like a foundation. It has the coverage of a foundation, like medium coverage, to be honest. Sometimes better coverage than my other foundations that I've used in the past. And what I like about it is that it also already has SPF 50. I don't know if you can see that. The sun is really trying me right now. Okay, let's see. There you go. The IT Cosmetics CC Cream. And this is in the color medium. I do have a smaller one in tan, which I mix because right now I'm a little bit darker than usual. Don't know if you can tell. Yeah, but this is usually the shade that I wear, and then I mix it a little bit with tan, and they work really, really good together. It gives me that sort of like dewy finish, but that's not too, it makes my skin look supple. That's what I'm trying to get at. It makes my skin look perfected. And it's already giving me the SPF, the sun protection that I need. And I'm telling you, everyone that I've ever said that my age too. I'm 37, by the way. They're like, whoa, really? What? How are you 37? And I'm like, yeah, I am 37. I turned 37 this year. And they were like, whoa, what's your secret? And I'm like, SPF. Ever since I was 15, SPF. So I'm happy that this has got sunscreen in it already, sun protection in it already. And I think that's one of the things that I love about it. Plus, yeah, it just gives my skin that luminosity without it making look greasy or oily. I haven't tried the illumination version of it. I don't think that I will, because this is giving me enough of a radiance. And then I hear that they came out with an actual foundation, but from the review of Emily Noel that I've seen, the foundation is actually sheerer than the CC cream. So what is the point, right? Okay, so yeah, that's my favorite face product, I would say. Another thing that I have really discovered much, and I don't think I already have a favorite of this, but it's like the translucent powders. I'm currently using the Tarte Smooth Operator one. I can't say that it's a favorite yet because I haven't tried very many others. I do have the RCMA one, but I still haven't used it, so I can't really say much. Okay, now, since we're talking about face products, for concealer, I have also tried a heck of a ton of concealers. And would you believe that my favorite is the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. And I have the shade 25 medium in this one. And I use this underneath my eyes to highlight. Now, this is still in an open one because I'm trying to use up all the other concealers that I have that are open. I've got my Becca Under Eye Corrector, Brightening Under Eye Corrector. I'm not a fan of this. I think I may have already said that in a video before, because it makes my under eyes look greasy. And I do have the MAC Conceal and Perfect. Is that correct? The MAC palette. This one is called, yeah, the Conceal and Correct palette in medium. Now I'm trying to use this up. I've gone through a bit of them. I want to use this up before I open any other concealers, just because I'm trying to get my money's worth out of the products that I have. So, but this isn't my favorite. It's good for when you really have a lot of problem areas. Like if I wanted to conceal that, I would have done so. But I'm fine with seeing my skin through my foundation. So yeah, I usually just use a concealer underneath my eyes, not to conceal any dark areas, because I don't really have very much of that, but more so to highlight that area. Whew. Okay, now I've talked about eye primer already, but for eyeshadow, my favorite formula is probably one of the more underrated formulas and products on YouTube, because I guess they don't really pay much for marketing. But I think this is a really, really good brand, and they really have a good diversity of products. And these are my Inglot eyeshadows. Okay, I've got Makeup Forever, I've got Zoeva, I've got MAC, I've got Kat Von D, what else do I have? I've got Dose of Colors, I've got Viseart eyeshadows, but I feel like these are the most versatile, and they are also one of the more affordable ones, I would say. You get a lot of product for what you pay for, and honestly, I have had some of these for years, and they still are really good, really pigmented, works really, really well. And I do also like the way they package it. It's a little bit heavy and bulky, but it's very, very sturdy. So yeah, those are my favorite eyeshadows that I am super in love with right now, along with my Makeup Forever ones. Okay, now for highlights, I don't think that I can beat Becca in terms of highlight. I did have one of their little palettes before that had two blushes, a bronzer and two highlighters, but now I have the collaboration with Chrissy Teigen, this one here, that's got a blush, two highlighters, and a bronzer. I don't really care much for the bronzer. I do like their blush. They're very pigmented, but you need to be quite careful with that. But their highlighters are some of the best that I've ever tried. In particular, this one here, which is called, what are you called? Beach Nectar, is the perfect highlighter for somebody with my skin tone. And I'll just show you quite quickly. I'm just gonna get this. and then boom, glowing for days. I just really like it. It's a really natural highlight for somebody with a skin tone like mine. I am, for reference, an NC35 to an NC40, depending on the season. But I really, really like it. Now, in terms of blush, I do have a lot of my MAC blushes. I do really like them because you can't really overdo them. The thing with blushes, I feel like, is if you do get a little bit heavy-handed on them, it makes you look like a clown. So I do love my MAC blushes. Let me just show you. I've got a bit of a collection here. So these are my MAC blushes. These are highlights and contours, and I do have a highlighter here as well. I think this is called Trace Gold. This is Sculpt, and I forget what this one is called. I think it's... Ooh, it starts with an E. I forgot what it's called, but anyway, all the rest of them are blushes, and they are my go-to blushes, especially when I just want that little shade on my face, a little bit of you. I do have a lot of NARS blushes as well, but I don't find them as nice as my MAC ones. I don't know, maybe it's just me. Now for lip products, I'm not really a lip liner person. I do own a lot of lip liners, like the Essence ones and the Giordano ones, but I don't use them all the time. For lipstick, by far my favorite formula of all time is the NARS Audacious Lipsticks. And I have Vanessa right here, which is probably my go-to shade. I do have Ingrid as well, which is a darker purple, a darker violet. And then for liquid lipstick formulas, I feel like Dose of Colors liquid lipstick is by far the best that I have tried. Got them on my lips right now. I've tried the ColourPop. I've tried Kat Von D. I've had the Stila ones. I hate the Stila ones. They dry my lips out so bad. I've got Ofra. What else have I got here? Yeah, I've got a lot actually. And I did have the Estee Lauder liquid ones as well. But those are very comfortable, but they don't really dry matte on the lips. They're just like a lip glossy kind of thing, like a more of a satin ones, like the ColourPop ones. By far, these are the most comfortable matte liquid lipsticks that I have tried, so I do like them. Now for mascara, I don't have a lot. I do have a lot of experience with mascara. By far, the best ones that I have used are the Lancôme ones, the Hypnose line that they have. These are probably the best mascaras that I have ever had. Am I even holding that right way? It's probably better, isn't it? Anyway, yeah, so those are my favorite ones from the drugstore. See, I don't even remember from the drugstore, so I probably don't have one from the drugstore. And then, am I missing anything? Oh, yeah, for contour, I've tried the Kat Von D ones. I have the Lorac Pro Contour, but really the only one that I keep coming back to are the e.l.f. contour kits. Really, seriously, $6 for four shades of contour. It's got bronzer, contour, highlight, and the sort of like a banana powder that you use for setting your under eye. The best. They are the best. I do really, really like them, and I'm happy to repurchase them every single time. I'm just using up my Lorac one, and then once that's done, I'm going back to e.l.f. because honestly, it doesn't have to be expensive to be good. All right, I think those are my favorite products that I've ever tried, and I feel like, yeah, I think I covered everything. Eyeliner. Ooh, eyeliner. Wait. The Stila Stay All Day liquid liner is the best one that I've tried. I have the Kat Von D Trooper, not as good, I would say. I also do really like the Maybelline Hyper Sharp eyeliners. They stay on for a long time. They don't smudge. Is this waterproof or is it like, oh, it doesn't even say that it's waterproof, but it doesn't smudge. It stays on my lash line all the time. I don't have eyeliner at the moment. You can probably tell. But yeah, those are my go-to products that if I could only keep one of each, or if I had to restart my collection and buy only the ones that I know work for me, those are the ones that I'm gonna go for. Yeah, so thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoy this video. I'm gonna go ahead and link the video of Mr. Ken Dennis so you can see what are his ultimate if I could only keep one product in my collection kind of answers to those questions, then go ahead and go and visit him. Now, before you leave though, make sure that you subscribe, comment down below what are your sort of holy grail, ride or die, if I could only keep one product. List them in the comment section down below. I would love to hear your thoughts about this. And if I haven't tried those products, I probably will. If they are available here in Australia, of course. And yeah, that's it for me. Thank you very much for joining me. And yeah, head over to Ken's channel and watch his answers to these questions. Bye!